Aaron, this video can show you how to use the terrain tool. So again, first of all, make sure you have Houdini engine installed. So here I have it installed. And then I can just drag and drop my tool in here. And it will generate a terrain, like you could see here. Now here then we have our settings for our tool. So here this is the type of the terrain. So I built a few presets that you can use. So the forest, mountain, and desert. So let's go to So this is currently forest. Then also we have mountains. So as you can see, we have some more mountain areas. And then we also have the desert area. This is then the desert. So let's just start out with the forest. We can always go back and forward when we want to. And we also here then have a seed slider. So if I want some variation, we can just play around with that. So it's always a good idea to have some variation, otherwise we will get always quite similar results. And then we can also here set the current size of my terrain. So this is 1000 units, but we can also make this smaller or bigger. So if you want like 500 units, we can press 500 and you can see that it's shrunk to these 500 units. So let's maybe go back to 1000 in this case. I think it was a good size here. And we can also have the resolution for this terrain. So currently I set it to a low resolution, so we have some values here we can use. So we have quite low, so medium and large, and also be careful with like the larger ones because they will of course take time to calculate. So if you want your tool to work really fast, keep it on low or maybe like one of the mediums. So if I would go a bit higher, the tool should also work pretty fast but might be less faster than the low version. So then let's go to input, so we can input certain objects. So I have adding and subtracting objects. So if I would now, let's for example take a something like maybe a sphere, and also going to give it this opacity material so we can actually see a bit more what's going on and maybe disable the collision. Then I can here use this and add a slot. So here I'm going to add a slot and I can fill in here a certain geometry. So I can, for example, here plug in my sphere. And as you can see, it immediately projects the sphere into my terrain. So if I would move the sphere around, we will also then move this mountain around. So currently it's not doing that in real time. But if I change the asset options here, if I would change the cook on transform here, it would actually work more in real time. So if I would change this, you can see it will automatically calculate. So of course, since we are working with a terrain, so it has to calculate quite a few things. It will take a few seconds to calculate, as you can see here. But this already is pretty cool to have working. So now I have this sphere, and I actually also built a blur shape. So this sphere is getting projected into the terrain, but we can also blur the shape a bit. So as you can see, we can blur down the shape to actually blend a bit better in the terrain, so we can have that. So now let's copy my sphere and do a subtraction. So here we can go to subtract, same thing. We can do, for example, add slot. We can drag the sphere in here, and this will then subtract from the terrain, as you can see. So maybe the blur was a bit too much, so let's keep it that lower. I think that's better. So we can hide the spheres here as well. So we can hide them. And then we can have like deep craters and like larger mountains if you want that. We can also use all the different shapes. Like if you want like this really specific shape to be projected in the terrain, we can do that as well. But I just use spheres here. So I might clear what I have here. And let's go to the settings now. So we can clearly see what's going on when I change the setting. So here I have like a default scale. So if I would increase this, I would sort of like zoom in on this terrain. So if I would lower this, we will basically sort of like zoom out of the noise. And this works with the other different modes. So if I have, for example, the mountain, we will see that we will have these high peaks a lot. So if I would zoom in, we sort of have only like this bigger part of these mountains. And also same with the desert, of course. As you can see here, we have like a more smaller desert with a few like desert dunes and so on. So I'm going to keep with the forest ground for now. Let's again keep it somewhere like here. Then we have like distortion. So you can already see like a little bit of noise here on the slopes of the object. So if I would increase this, you can see that this is more heavier. Now next up here is the slump amount. So let's bring this to zero so you can clearly see what it's doing. And it is most noticeably when an area is more flat. So here in this case, if I would crank this up, you can see that this will sort of like cover it in dirt. So this is great to sort of like simulate a dirt layer on top of this. So you can see that if I would disable this, we can see all this noise. And if we enable this, we can have like a dirt layer on this. I also built in here an opacity slider so we can like blend a bit between them if you want to. Then further here we then have a height scale so we can, if you think the height was too much of the terrain, we can like squeeze it, or we can also do the other way around, increase this. We can also do a height offset, so we can offset the height in case we need to match a certain other different height, but I'm going to keep this to default values. Now comes a really interesting part, and that is the simulation here. So currently my 3D doesn't look that nice. It looks very basic with some noise in there. So I want to actually do a certain erosion simulation. So I can enable this here, but once I enable this, this will also take time to calculate, of course, because it's going to calculate a multiple frames of simulation. So, and as you can see here, we are getting a more detailed terrain. So if I would quickly switch between them, we can see that our shapes are getting a bit more natural by doing this simulation. And we can always go back and forward. So if I would, for example, go here, change the noise again, we can then have something like this. So this will look a bit natural. We can also, for example, here increase the erosion time, like set it to 20. So we double it. And then we can also here have the some global erosion rates, so hydro rate and thermal rate. So hydro rate is basically the lines it is creating. So if you don't want the lines, like you could see here, like these lines, like things are like falling down from the mountain. So if you don't want these lines, we can lower this value and it will also remove the lines. So if I basically set this to zero, it will basically, as you can see, like the lines are gone now. So we have like a more clean look there. And then the thermal erode, is basically sort of like the shaping of these mountains. So as you can see, before we had like quite noisy structure, and then here we have like some more thermal erode. So again, you can play around with this value on how intense this should be. Of course, as you could see now, the quality is also pretty low. So if you want to have a more high res, we can always go here, switch to, for example, like a 1K maybe. And you can see that we can have some more details in here. I can also see I have a little bit more noisiness in these areas. So it's a bit more detailed. The last thing here, I've also built in a start simulation button. So by default, it will try to auto-bake your erosion, but sometimes we need to click the start simulation to refresh the simulation. So it's going to basically update with your new settings. Then we can also export textures. So in here, we can get the height map and some of the layer systems that I built into textures. So here, the only thing we have to do is we need to save out a certain file location where I want to save it. So in my case, I'm going to put it under assets, textures, and then terrain. So here I have a, so here under textures, I have a folder straight out. So if I press now render, it will then save these files here, but I don't see them here at the moment. So we might need to, so if I open here my Windows browser, I can see I have these maps here. So once I go back in Unity, they are actually also loaded now. And let's take a closer look at these maps. So I have my height map. This is the height map of my terrain. Then I also have a layer system. And I have two layers here, so for grass and for the sort of like cliff, so I have two layers there. Then I also have a mask for certain noises, so maybe just zoom in like this. And we will have sort of the erosions and the water simulation from the erosion simulation can be exported here into texture if you want to use this in a advanced shader. Now, last thing here as well, we can also add a material. So here I have a Unity basic material, but you can use, of course, your custom material. So that's it for all the settings, but I also want to go in a bit more deeper, and I'm going to click on the terrain itself, and I'm going to go here to where I'm going to paint my terrain, and I'm going to go and switch to paint texturing mode. So in here, what you could see is we actually created two layers automatically from Houdini. So basically the texture I had here is actually already stored in the terrain itself by default. So the only thing we have to do is I need to assign a certain material here. So I'm going to go to my textures, and here I have a layer called cliffs. So I'm going to assign my cliff material here. You can see it already working. We have then these cliffs. Maybe just scale it to a better size, maybe 100. And you can see we have the cliffs. So I can do the same here with my normal map. And I can do the same then also for my grass. So we have the grass and the grass normal, and then maybe scale this up to 50 by 50. Like so. And then I have like a really basic terrain, and this is automatically done by Houdini, this grass and cliff layer. So you don't have to worry about that. So if I now would play around with my seed value, so let's say I want to have a different version, we can quickly get a different version, and it's getting automatically baked here in a few seconds. As you can see here, we then have a new version of that. So you can still keep playing around, tweak values until we got the terrain you want. So that was it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and thank you for watching.